Alright, I'm back again. Update on the 29-gallon 10-gallon kitchen tank. So all the fish are doing okay. Neon Tetra's looking a little fatter. Quarries have grown a lot since the accident with my, with the guppies that I had. I never got any video of what happened. Well, they all got a disease and died off, but aside from that horrible memory, So the dwarf satch has been getting some new growth. Let's see if I can get one. That little piece right there, that little curve right there is new growth. I don't see any new growth on that one. Not on this one, or this one, or that one. I think the one back there has some new growth, and I have to replant that. I didn't see that up there. All the female cockatoides have acclimated, and they're doing great. Going around the tank, male's usually staying on this half. I don't know why he doesn't go over there for some reason. At least not anymore. I moved the female agassi out of here. She was being too aggressive to the female cockatoides. So all the female cockatoides are in breeding condition. Really, really nice gold color. I don't want to see them out of that gold color, because then that means they're done breeding for now, and don't want to see that. See if I can get a picture here right there. Alright, fruit tetras are doing fine. Syrup pies have gotten really big, and, lemon tetras haven't grown that much, but they're doing fine. We got Gudgeon gobies coming out a lot more often since I put the plants in here. The colors are amazing. If you find this fish, again, I'll say it again, definitely get this fish if you ever find it, because it's probably not going to show up again for a while. I got a rare opportunity. These guys are great. I thought they were bigger, but I didn't want them to be that big because, I mean, I needed a bigger tank and blah, 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 blah. I didn't want to do that. Water sprite is humongous now. All that green is just water sprite. Water sprite, one strand of anchorses, and one strand of another plant. The roots on this one are massive. The tea is doing okay. Let's see. Alright, I forgot to do the back to basics videos. I think I'll start that tomorrow. Basically, it'll just be how to do water changes, different types of lights, beginner plants, and other advanced plants things. What else? Changing water, testing your water. So yeah, just basic stuff. Cleaning out a sponge filter. I would do cleaning out filters, but there are too many different types of filters, and blah, 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 I don't really give a crap. So let's see, there's a female, if you can see her back there, a female Gudgeon goby. There she is, she's coming out, ready to get out of the way. There she is. Female has black lines, not for all the ones, because sometimes the male has black lines, sometimes they don't. So my female has black edges on all their fins. My male only has black edges on the anal fin. So really, it's just their genetics. Let's see. So I'm just gonna do a little short thing. Unexpectedly in this, just to show you how I replant these plants. Let's see if I can get that. Alright. So basically what you do is you take your top and you put it up a little bit. Take your plant. Just push Oh gosh, water might feel a little bit cooler. Like this water's 74 degrees, but it feels a lot colder. Just because that's the way things are. Just once you plant it, you want to make sure it's down deep in there. If you have dirt, make sure it's not touching the dirt, just a little bit above so it can grow into it. I don't have dirt on this. I don't have dirt yet. I might get dirt on this tank. So just pull up a little bit after you plant it so you don't see the roots, but you see basically what they call the crown, which is basically where the roots start. And then done. I planted a little bit of water sprite in there. I don't know if it's going to do well or not. I gotta push that down a little bit. Let me adjust the camera so you can see that. Zoom in a little bit. So this right here is Lutea. It's a crypt from the family Cryptonine or something like that. It's a beginner plant, I'm pretty sure. When you first buy these plants, crypts, they go through something called crypt melt, which is basically where the plant kind of breaks down for maybe a week or two, possibly longer. They should survive it if you have the right conditions. That plant just floated up. Here, just broke off a little piece. Push that down in there. Pull it up. This piece right here. I gotta separate this. Piece there. Stick it down underneath. Oh, and I'll do a say for Back to the Basics. I'll be doing a segment, or I might do a segment on preparing plants for the tank, getting them ready and stuff, planting them. I might be ordering a tool for that. I hope I do. At least I hope I can, because it looks really cool. It looks really helpful. It probably is, and I don't have to stick my hand in the tank every time I have to do something with the plants. If you have sand, sometimes the sand might get stuck in your fingernails. Just poke it out. Let's see. Do I have anything else up here? I think I might plant this water right here. Nah. Okay. Here, I'll do this thing on water sprite, real quick. Oops. Alright, if you can see, it looks like two plants, but really, that plant right there is growing off of that leaf, if you can see it. See, it doesn't come off. It's growing off of that leaf, and that's how they're going to grow, and then once they're old enough, they'll just separate, and then you've got a brand new plant. In fact, I could just break that off right now. And then voila, voila, new plant. Water sprite, you can grow it planted. So I'm thinking about trying that. I don't think I will right now. Make sure you always have a towel or something. Like, I have this towel right here, right next to my tank. So when I'm done with water stuff, I can just dry off my hand. I'll just give you a view of the tank for real quick. I'll dry off. I'm not sure if you can see her right now, but right there, the little thing that just flicked around is one of the female coccatoides. I think it's the pure orange flash, because there are two types of orange flash that I've already discussed. One of them, this is the first one that I got, is, I don't actually know what the name is, so I just made up a name, which is pretty much what people do anyway. I call it, what was it, orange flash black spot, which is basically what it is. It's just orange flash with a whole bunch of black spots. Pure orange flash is literally just orange. Nice shade of orange. One of my favorites, that I'm pretty sure you can see has that. It's called a pistol room. If you look at it long enough, you'll find the one that I'm talking about. You'll see it. You'll know when I see it. I gotta move. Let me just take off this rock so the can have a larger carpet, and I can plant some Anubis. Take that rock out. And the Anubis wouldn't really stick to the wood, so I'm kind of done with that. I'll just plant this right here. When you're planting Anubis, make sure you don't plant the rhizome. Blah, 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 blah. I think I already said that. Just completely bury it, and then pull it up. A lot of sand here. Oh, dang it. Here we go. Okay, forget that. I'm just gonna plant it in the wood again. There we go. And now to once again replant this. I'm pretty sure you already know when you're when you buy new fish, you have to acclimate them, blah, blah, and let them sit for 15 minutes. Plants, you basically have to do the same thing, except you have the duration time is shorter, and they still have to acclimate and everything, like just regular fish, kept their plants. Still have to let them acclimate and everything. There you go. That's nice. Some take it better than others. Like I said, crips will usually die back and then come die and come back or regrow or whatever. So let me get hold of the camera again. So this one is pure orange flash, or not pure orange flash, black spot. You can't see it, but on her tail she has black lines around her orange flash. Cory's in my cave that I made for them. I didn't actually make it for them, but they like it anyway. Beta staring me down. Another basic would be feeding fish and making sure you don't overfeed them, and ways to feed them while you're on the cave. Here, there's the male cockatoidy. Don't have much light right now. I wish you could see him better. Maybe on this side? Nope, not enough light. Maybe if I move this water sprite over. There we go. There's the light. That sounded cheesy, but I don't really care. Alright, so you can see, I thought this was double red at first, but it kind of looks like red, but it's really an orange flash variety, orange flash. Black spot or black line. I'm trying to get a view on that. Two of the females are by my cave that I made for them. Hoping that they'll breed. Okay. Obviously, one is claimed territory. And that one was being attacked by the female Azizi or Agazi. I don't know why. I guess it's kind of like a territory thing. See, she's making sure she stays out of their breeding zone. Her tail's a little bit messed up. It'll grow back eventually. Or at least I hope so. If not, she'll deal with it. Other fish have. Peacock and gobies. Definitely get them. I'll do an Info Tuesday on them. I think I probably will change that name because I don't like it. Doesn't ring like Species Sunday. Bloody bloody blah. Alright. Time for the 10 gal. Alright, 10-gallon kitchen tank. Female black guppy. Really fat. She's probably going to pop anytime soon. Probably while I'm gone. She's gotten bigger. Corey's doing okay. I've moved some dwarf sag in here because my other plants weren't doing so well, and I just thought maybe a nice complete carpet on this tank would be look nice instead of a whole bunch of different plants. So, you can see, let me try and get a different angle.
I don't think you can see that, but that little tiny green speck right there is new growth.
Their fins are a little ragged because I think they're fighting. But, yeah, get over it. I'm going to fill this tank back up. Like I said, water sprite, which roots are massive. Automatic feeder, do that later. Alright, ceiling.